High and Mighty was the studio album.
Okay.
Mighty High is a dub remix for the most part. There's maybe one full studio track in there, actually two. There's the version of I'm a Ram that still has some dub stuff in it, mm-hmm. but the version of Shape I'm In, the band song, is a full-out studio version. The rest of it is what you'd call a dub remix. Well, let me go back a little bit. Number one is sometimes during our jams on stage, there would be these reggae moments that would come out. Maybe that was from having a keyboard player having that sort of influence. But for sure, we were exploring it at an improvisational level. Also, when we were recording High and Mighty, which is the studio album that preceded Mighty High, our producer, co-producer, Gordie Johnson, he co-produced the record with Warren, was very much a dub music aficionado. And by dub music, I mean the remix stuff that comes out of Jamaica. And so on occasions when we were listening to the end of the day playbacks, or we were making rough mixes to take home, Gordie would do a little dub thing, put a little delay into it, you know. So when the drum hit, it would go bok, 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 or whatever, you know. And we were cracking up, and we kept saying, well, this is for the dub album. This is for the dub album. And then as time went by, it just became as intriguing as anything, you know, else we could think of. And Gordie wanted to take it on. And so he took live performances, mixed it with other live performances, studio stuff, got Michael Franti to rap, got extra reggae guests to rap, and put this thing together in much the same way that reggae dub records are made. Mm-hmm. Three versions of one song, each one slightly different. So that's basically how it happened, how it came about.
And are you guys working on a new album by any chance, or any plans to do so?
Well, it's going to be next year for sure, if it happens that quickly. There's a lot on tap. There's a tour coming up in the fall. Continued involvement with the Allman Brothers, because they missed a lot of gigs last year, so Warren will be doing, I'm sure, a bunch of that. But I think you can look for a new record next year, yeah.
Well, one last thing I wanted to ask you about while I've got you here is, in February we checked in with Dave Schools, a bandmate from Stockholm Syndrome, so I was wondering if you might have any new Stockholm news to share.
Well, the best news I can tell you is that the last call I got from Dave, Jerry Joseph was in the background, and there was guitar playing, and they were smoking cigarettes and drinking coffee, so that sounds like to me like there might be some new songs happening. That said, we'll have to wait and see.
Oh, boogie.net, ha, that's what you get. Ha!